What's up, you guys? Sasha here. Today I'm going to tell you the 10 different ways in which you can stop wasting money every single time you go to the supermarket. From crazy expensive stuff you really don't need to spend your money on, or things that are horribly overpriced, to the other end of the spectrum when there's just things you really don't need to buy and you can buy alternatives instead, which will save you a huge amount of money. We're going to go through them one at a time. Just before that, I think number zero way that you can save money, zero because we're about to cover the 10 other ones. Anyway, the number zero is stop going every single day. This is a really super simple thing. This is something that so many people are guilty of. On the way back from work or just to get out of the house, they're going to go to the shop every single day, or sometimes every other day, whatever it is, stop doing that. Go to the shop at least every few days, once a week, whatever works for you. Most food that you buy will last you a week or 10 days or whatever it is that you need. Every single time you go to the shop, you're wasting money on parking, you're wasting money on transport to get there, petrol, whatever it is. So that's one good reason. Another good reason is time, and that's probably the biggest one. The amount of time that you're spending on just getting to the shop, spending time in the shop, queuing up to pay for it, checking out, all of that is a huge, huge waste of time. If you can eliminate that from your everyday or every other day routine and just go once a week, you're gonna find yourself incredibly time rich and you can do whatever you want with that time. Anyway, let's jump right into the list. At number one on my list of pet hates, as well as on my list of massive waste of money, is pod coffee. This is so popular, especially with the younger crowd. So this is your Nespresso machines or any other type of pod coffee thing. You buy these little aluminium pods that you stick into the machine and you press a button, stick a cup under it, and bang, you've got a cup of coffee. Now, it is super easy and incredibly convenient. I get it. But there are two really massive reasons why it's a bad idea. The first one is the whole point of why we're having this conversation, it's the money. These pods, depending on which particular type you buy, depending on the machine that you use, will cost something between 25 and 40p per pod. Now you can buy massive packets and they will cost a lot less per pod, or you can buy the smaller ones which will cost more, but generally speaking, that's the sort of price range. The average tends to be about 30-35p per pod, and that generates you one small, regular cup of coffee. Now that might not sound like a lot, but if you say doing two cups of coffee or three cups, or well, some people like to have more than that, maybe as much as 5 to 10 cups of coffee a day. Some people. Then you're spending quite a lot of money suddenly on coffee. Now different people like their coffee different ways, but generally speaking, you can make your own coffee using either ground coffee or coffee beans or any other method like that where you actually have to brew it in some way for a lot less money. Even if you are a bit of a coffee snob and you like your coffee from actual beans using one of those fancy machines, you're still going to be spending considerably less. Even if you're buying some nice coffee beans in bags, typically those bags come in 200, 250, 300, 400 gram sizes, you're going to be spending something in the region of about 10p per cup of coffee on the beans that you're using, which is a massive saving. That's about 100 quid a year if you're only doing one cup of coffee. If you're doing any more, that's many hundreds or thousands a year in savings. That's considerable. The second reason you shouldn't do it is because it's just incredibly bad for the environment. I mean, those aluminium pods themselves are pretty bad. They have those plastic things on top that you either rip off or kind of get pierced or whatever it is. It's just horrific. Just one cup of coffee, you're going to be throwing away that entire pod, and it's going to be hanging around for tens of thousands or millions or however long it takes for the stuff to degrade, years. If you stick it in recycling, it probably won't get recycled anyway because it's mixed materials and nobody will be bothered to separate them, and also nobody will know what exactly it's lined with, and it might be dirty and contaminated with food. Anyway, just don't do it. Just don't use those pods. Go and make your own coffee at home, however you like to make it. It really doesn't take that long. It tastes better and it saves you a huge amount of money. And number two, I've got buying branded stuff versus supermarket own brand things when you're shopping for various goods. And I get it, in some cases you want the nice quality, the premium kind of goods, because they're fundamentally better. And if you're trying to buy beer, for example, the premium branded stuff will in most cases taste considerably better than the cheap supermarket own brand stuff that you might find somewhere at the back. And I get in those cases you might want to go and spend a bit more money. But on so many other things, it just makes absolutely zero sense. If you're buying tinned food, if you're buying things like tinned tomatoes or beans or anything else like that, if you're buying meat that is packaged, if you're buying any of those other types of products, it is a huge waste of money to be going and buying one of the branded versions instead of the supermarket versions, because they often come from the same places. The same farmers supplying their meat or their tomatoes or their whatever to the different places where these products get manufactured. In some cases, the same exact product will be manufactured at the same factory with just different packaging and different labels being placed on top of it. In some cases, there might be a genuine difference. You might be buying a particular kind of beef or whatever it is that you like buying, and maybe then you might consider buying something specialty. But if you're just buying regular food and you have the choice of the two and one is a quarter of the price of the other, just don't waste your money. It really isn't worth it almost every single time. Number three, I've got the scoffing at buying the cheapest version of any product in the supermarket, the value, the essential, the whatever range of products that you might see on the shop floor. And this is the thing that I really dislike. When the supermarkets make these things, they exist for the people who really watch their pockets, really watch their wallets, but they make sure that the people who have a bit more money really don't want to buy them. These things will typically be hidden somewhere out of view. They're not going to be at the sort of eye level part of the supermarket. They're going to be somewhere on the bottom or hard to find parts of the aisles. They're going to look pretty bad. There's going to be very bland packaging. It's going to have very minimal effort put into how it looks and how it's designed, and that is on purpose. It will look like something you really don't want to buy, and because the packaging is so bland and neutral and doesn't have any pictures on it, it must be really bad, right? Well, no, in many cases that just isn't the case. There are some products where the quality of the essential range is just as good as any other supermarket own brand or even branded product. Especially for things where you really can't have much of a differentiation in the quality of the product that you can't see. Like for example, if you're buying beans and there's a premium branded version, there's a supermarket own brand version, and then there's the essential value, the cheapest possible range that you really don't want to buy, that doesn't look good. That cheapest one is probably going to be considerably cheaper than the other two, and I would wager that you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between the taste of those three products if you had to do a blind test. And top tip, if you are a cheese fan and you like your Parmesan, the best Parmesan I've ever bought in the UK supermarket, or actually in any UK shop for that matter, is the Waitrose Essential Parmesan. So go and try those things out. And number four, I've got a really short suggestion. Avoid the snacks and the chocolate aisle. Just avoid them. You don't need those massive packs of crisps. You don't need those biscuits. You don't need those endless chocolate bars and wine gums and whatever else that you're sticking in your supermarket trolley and you really don't want to be buying it, but you're gonna buy it anyway. Just don't go there, save a ton of money, look better, feel healthier. Just don't do it. Let's skip to the next one. The next one is, whenever you're buying an item where you're buying it regularly all the time, every single time you go to the shop, you buy one or two of these things, and those things get sold in multi-packs or some kind of like large quantity discount, go and buy the large quantity discount version. Don't buy the one-off product, because usually you'll pay considerably more. I mean, by all means, compare. Sometimes people will charge you more for the privilege of buying a pack of something because it's easier to carry or whatever, it looks more attractive. But in most cases, that's just not true. So for example, if you're buying products like tins and you can buy a pack of 4 or 16 of them or whatever, usually they'll be much cheaper than buying the one-off tins and putting a load of them into your trolley instead. If you're buying beer, don't buy the one bottle of beer or the four pack. If you buy it all the time and you have it over a period of time, go and buy a whole box of it. You don't have to drink the whole thing that week. You can go and put it somewhere in the back of your house and get out the beers you need when you want them. They'll cost so much less per bottle. It's a massive saving. Especially for goods that have long shelf lives that you don't need to be buying every single week, go and see if you can buy a lot of that stuff and then use it as and when you need it. The same goes for snack-sized versions. These are often things that you'll find close to the checkout or sometimes at the end of the aisles. So you'll have a big bag of nuts that might be costing you, say, £2, and then at the end you'll have a small snack-sized version of the same nuts where you're getting a tiny fraction of what the big bag has, and it'll cost you £1.50. It'll cost you 3/4 of what the giant bag costs. Just don't do it. Just go and buy the big bag. Take the portion that you need, put it somewhere towards the back of the cupboard, and then next time you need it, it's there. You don't have to spend any more money. And number six, I've got something that's become really, really popular in the last few years. It is pre-cut everything. So you've got pre-cut vegetables, you've got pre-cut fruit, you've got pre-cut meat. And I really don't get it, because in some cases this costs 2, 3, 5, or even 10 times as much as the actual things that you can buy right next to the pre-cut versions. just for the privilege of not having to cut it yourself. I mean, those pre-cut free packets, we usually have a small bit of apple or something, and it will cost considerably more than a whole bag of apples that you can buy right next to it. It'll take you literally a number of seconds to go and chop up some bits of apple. Chopped up meat is absolutely horrific. You can buy the mini fillets of chicken, or you can buy the diced lamb or diced pork or whatever, so that you don't have to cut the cubes or the pieces of meat yourself when you're doing a barbecue. It takes a few seconds and you can actually get way better quality and way more meat, or way more whatever pre-cut thing that you're buying. Just don't buy the pre-cut versions. And number seven, I've got wine. Now, wine is a weak spot of mine. I buy it a lot, I like it. I get quite into trying to figure out which wines I like and which ones I don't like. There's a few ways in which you can waste a huge amount of money when buying wine. Number one is the premium section. This will be the one which will have the wood panels and the better lighting and the more space between the bottles of wine when you're trying to pick which bottle you want. Now, in that section, the wine will probably be nicer than in the regular section where you're having them stacked on the shelves. But generally speaking, they're so horribly overpriced that you're just throwing money away. The second thing is, when you look at a wine section in the supermarket, the stuff that you can see in front of you at your eye level is generally going to be the most overpriced out of the different kinds of wine you can buy. But the ones where the margins are a bit less, and the ones where the supermarket might not be earning quite as much from each bottle, are going to be placed in various other places, look near the floor. So some of those wines are going to be for cooking, they're going to be the cheapest possible wines you can buy. Others are going to be actually pretty good. Go and just inspect the entire range before you go and settle on the one that's placed right in front of you. Face. The third thing to look out for with wine is the premium versions of brands that are generally speaking quite cheap. So supermarkets buy a huge quantity of wine from some of the really big mass producers in Europe in particular. You have these Spanish wines and Italian wines where there's just hundreds of thousands of bottles being produced from millions of different vineyards, and they're all blended, and sometimes they don't even have a particular year stamped on them. A lot of these producers will then produce a premium version of their wine, which in some way will be a little bit better. It might use slightly better grapes or might be aged a bit more, but they'll be pricing it at like three or four times the price of the cheap stuff. And in many cases, the difference is really not worth it. So try to avoid buying those types of wines as well. In general, supermarkets are not the best place to be buying wine. Sometimes there's good deals to be had, and if you know which particular bottles are good value there, it might be worth it. But if you can, you have the time, go and visit a wine merchant or order some wine from an online wine dealer. You'll usually be able to get much more interesting, much better quality wine for much better prices than you can get in a regular supermarket. Number eight is magazines and newspapers. Now, I see a lot of people buying magazine, they're standing there choosing which one they should get, and I get it, it's nice to go and read something, but there's two really big problems with this. Number one, you can often get access to exactly the same content and the same information, the same materials online, either for free or for a fraction of the cost the actual magazine costs. Now, if you want to go and buy a newspaper, generally speaking, every single piece of information that you see in the newspaper will be available online. And some of the broadsheets like Daily Mail and other similar things are completely free to go and use online, so you can go and do that instead. Other ones like the Telegraph, the Times, the Financial Times, whatever is your preference, they have some form of a paywall, but generally speaking, that paywall will be so much less money than the cost of buying a physical newspaper that you might want to go and do that instead. If you do like physical papers or physical magazines and you just enjoy flicking through them, go and get yourself a subscription. It is unbelievable how much cheaper a subscription is than buying the individual magazines or newspapers. If you buy them regularly, if you buy them even not that regularly but from time to time, a subscription will save you a huge amount of money. Sometimes a subscription costs the price of two of the magazines, and you're going to get a whole year's worth of the monthly editions. Whatever you do, just go and get a subscription. Stop buying the physical copies. It's a massive waste of money. Number nine, we've got the deli section. Generally speaking, you can buy everything that is available in the deli section somewhere else in the supermarket. And aside from the fact that you usually have to queue and then have to ask a person to get you the thing, it's often a really bad price on the stuff as well. I get it, it feels really premium. Instead of buying the regular sliced ham in a packet from some kind of shelf that you have to go and find, you can go and ask a person and they can manually go and slice the ham for you and put it into a nice little container. But one, The dates on all of these things are going to be considerably shorter, so you have less time to use the food and it goes off a lot more quickly. Number two, in many cases, it's exactly the same stuff as you can buy over in the other part of the shop, but you're paying for the premium of there being a person that serves you with the food instead of you being able to pick it out yourself. And in some cases, this food is actually going to be objectively worse. The stuff that's packaged up in a protective environment, etc., is going to be much more fresh, is going to tastes good. If something's been in a deli for a day or two, it's going to be way less fresh, and there are things that are lying there for days and days, like those giant rolls of cut up cheese. Some of these cheeses are going to be lying there for quite a long time before they actually get used up. It really isn't worth it. Just stop using the deli aisle. There's much better deals to be had in the rest of the shop. And number 10 and last in the list is bottled water. And I see a lot of people loading the giant bottles of water into their trolleys. These bottles have water that comes from the top of a snow-capped mountain or from a special sacred spring or whatever it is. Truth is, nobody is climbing to the top of the mountain to get the most pristine, perfect bottle of water for you. This water is going to be pretty much exactly the same as the stuff you can get from the tap. In the UK, tap water is perfectly good pretty much everywhere you live. Now, I know in some cases, if you don't have running water, if you live in a very specific area, maybe you have to buy bottled water, but for the 99% of us, the stuff from the tap is cold, it's perfectly drinkable, it's tasty, it's good for you, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it. Now, I get that some people like, for example, buying sparkling water or some kind of flavored drink or whatever it is. Sure, I'm not completely against any form of bottled anything, but just the regular everyday water, you really do not need to buy the bottles. You're throwing away all that plastic for completely no reason whatsoever. Go and use the tap. Get your glass, stick it under the tap, fill it with water, perfect. I hope you guys like this. Please tell me what other massive waste of money I haven't mentioned on my list or I've forgotten to mention in the comments below. I'd love to read a bit more and have a bit of discussion. If you like this video, please, please give this video a like. It really helps the YouTube algorithm. And if you are interested in topics about money, about making money, about keeping more of the money and using financial products in the best possible way, make sure you subscribe to this channel. I've got videos coming out every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Make sure you hit the bell so you get notifications and you don't miss a single video. I'll see you guys later.